Yeah.
Thomas, it's Farrell. Running from the Bureau will do no good. You know we'll find you eventually. Look, I understand. The caseload became too much. You weren't solving cases like you used to. You're talented, high-strung. You snapped. It happens sometimes.
But I did not snap. Someone else killed those policemen. It looks like it might have been the matchmaker.
With your gun? That seems unlikely, doesn't it? We have psychiatric staff that can help you sort things out.
With all due respect, I don't need a shrink. Look, Farrell.
This isn't Farrell. It's Malcolm Van Horn. Has your boss been bothering you?
Yes.
To be expected. They're not going to let this drop. You must continue with your investigation. Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes. I mean, no. What do you want from me, Malcolm? What's going on?
Going on? You're being investigated by the FBI for the murder of two police officers. That's what's going on. You will be tested, Thomas. Of that you can be sure. I must go.
received. Right-handed print, missing the right index finger. This matches what we got from the crime scene. I processed all the prints. And Thomas, the print you got from the tape recorder at the metro station isn't on this hand.
I don't get it. What does that mean?
I'm not sure. I'm just saying that the print from the tape recorder wasn't made by the same hand. Size and dispersal pattern indicate victim sustained a heavy blow. Height of blood on the wall indicates it's possibly a head wound.
Thank you.
cross-referencing. The footprint is an exact match to the print I found in the metro station car. It may be the matchmaker, but I'm still concerned about that rogue fingerprint from the tape recorder. Keep following the trail. It may lead to answers. Maybe even a body.
I would if I could, but this part of the department store is flooded. His trail ends here.
It might be a long shot, but try using your gas spectrometer. Dead bodies start decaying immediately, producing hydrogen sulfide and traces of methane. If there's a body, you should be able to sniff it out. The air sample contains usual city pollutants and high concentrations of mold spores, and here we go, methane. It's relatively weak, but definitely there. Received. Well, what do we have here? A matchmaker scene. But it's not quite right. Looks like you have a male corpse and a female mannequin. Exactly the opposite of normal. Well, not normal. Thomas, photograph the victim's face.
This guy's the matchmaker. Well, he certainly didn't kill himself and set it up this way.
See what else you can find. Damn. No usable DNA traces. Killer must have worn gloves. But there is something.
What is it?
Too early to call. Small particles that show up as a potential organophosphate pesticide. I'll work more on that and see what we get.
We know you're in here. Keep yourself out!
What the fuck? Fucking
stop!
Something, Thomas. The newspaper clippings you found in the room at the metro station, each of the articles talks about a serial killer. A serial killer that was on your case list. 9 names were mentioned. Of those, 7 of the 9 were crossed out in each of the clippings by a black felt tip marker. The only names that weren't crossed out were the matchmaker and the torturer. Of the names that were crossed out, all those cases have gone cold.
And now you can cross off the matchmaker. Wait, are you implying that there's someone stalking serial killers? So what, he goes around killing killers and then he marks off their name in his little personal diary?
Sounds ridiculous, doesn't it?
It does, but it adds up. It almost makes sense. Hold on. Ah, shit. Rosa, I have to call you back.
Come on.